हेलो एवरीवन, सो लेट्स सी द न्यू पैकेट रेसर। दिस इज ए पैकेट रेसर वर्जन 8। इफ यू सी वर्जन 8.0.0. दिस वन, सो हियर द सिस्को मेक सम मॉडिफिकेशन। लाइक इफ यू वांट टू चेक द फिजिकल व्यू, यू कैन चेक लाइक रियल सिनेरियो इन योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, हाउ यू विल इंस्टॉल एंड हाउ इट लुक एंड हाउ केबल्स आर देयर। यू कैन सी दैट वन ऑल्सो, एंड वी कैन यूज़ द कंट्रोलर। बिफोर वी डोंट हैव हियर, नाउ वी हैव द नेटवर्क कंट्रोलर ऑल्सो। वी कैन यूज़ दिस कंट्रोलर ऑल्सो एंड वी कैन मैनेज अवर डिवाइस बाई यूजिंग द कंट्रोलर, लाइक SDN और द सिस्को नेटवर्क कंट्रोलर वी हैव। सो दे ऐड दिस वन कंट्रोलर एज वेल एज दे मेक द फिजिकल वी लुक मोर अट्रैक्टिव। सो हाउ वी कैन चेक, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स सी फिजिकल लुक। सो इफ यू गो हियर इन द फिजिकल यू विल सी दिस वन। And if you click this one, this again, this is the main wiring. You can click here, so you will see this as a rack. If you make this, before we have this one, but not all features, they add more features. If you click this one, you will see this one, how you have the routers installed in the rack and how cables are there. And if you want to make manage all the cable, this will move. Before we have like this way. But if you want to see all cables, how they are connected, just right click here and click unmanage. So it will look how physically it is connected. Example, if you are working in a data center, you will see so many routers, switches, servers, and all cables are going like this. So in old version, we don't have this option. In the new version, we can make this more zoom like this, and you can check. And if you want to change the cable color also, you can change. You can go like color cable and which color you want to keep. Example, if you want to keep this color as a red, you can write red and you can make change so it will become red. Whatever cable color you want, you can give. And what else means you can, if you want to add one more rack here, you can go here, you can check here rack. You can click this one so it will come one more rack. And if you want to install the router here, you can go here, you can take this router. It look like you are really installing the router in your organization. Let me make this little big so you will have the idea. See here, I am taking this router. I am going here. I want to install here in this location. So I will leave this one. So we have the router and the power adapter. And if I want to take the server, I will go here. I will take any server and I will install like this. And if I want to connect the cable, I will take this cable. I will connect from here or wherever option. Example, from here to here, I can connect. If you don't want to show this cable, go here, manage, so it will go beside the server. But if you want to check how it look, put the unmanaged, so it will show you how it is hanging and from where it is connected. And you can make the zoom in more this one. And you can feel like you are working in the real scenario. Whenever you are working in the organization, you will have like this only, all the cables are like this. And you are removing and putting, and you are doing cable tie here. Like technicians are doing, you need to guide them how to do, what to do. And what else you can see here? Example, if you want to see more options here, this is a logical view, this one. This is a logical view, but this is a physical view, how it is looking. If you go here, this is a router R2, R1, R3, R4, and the switch. And whatever we use here. And if you want to check the more device, go here, click this one, you will have this option. You can see here whatever devices are available. Which device you want to check, you can click that device. Example, I want to check the PC. Where is the PC? This one. I changed the name PC to this IP address. Remember? So I will click this one so you will see this one. So what we can do here, if you want to add the PC in the same room, we can go here, we can check here, there is a table. I will click this one. So we will have one table here. Okay, see here we have the table. If you don't need this rack, I will remove this rack. Just go here, click here, delete this rack. It will delete this one. Now I have the table here. So what I can do, I can add the PCs, whatever PC. So how I can add, I can go here, click this one, and I can drag this one and drop here. So this PC came here. See here, this PC came here. If you want to move this one also here, drag here. So you will have this PC also. So you have the two PC. If you can keep this one, PC is connected to switch. If you want to take switch, you can take. If you have another rack, you can install. And if you want to make this down, you can make down. Wherever you want, you can do that one. Okay. An example, if you want to move this router here, you can move this one. Like you think, like you really you are working in the organization like that. By seeing this picture, you can feel environment like you are in the doing practically removing or doing something. Like this we can do. If you want to add more devices, more city, we can add from here, as I told you. And what else we can do means, let me show you about the controller also. Example, let me go in the logical way. This is a controller. So what I will do, I will take one cable. I will connect this controller to this switch. And I need to assign the IP address to this controller. So I will go here. I will go here, this one. I will assign the IP address. So we use 192.168.1.2. So I will assign this one as a 1.3. And then I will go here and I will check. I will define here default gateway 192.168.1.1. Okay. It is not taking anyhow. Later we will check. So after that one, you need to enable this one. By default, this is disabled. You need to go here in the option preference. And here miscellaneous, you need to enable these two option. Before, by default, Cisco disable this one. You need to enable this two. So you will have this option. You can go here and in the controller, you can enable this one. Remember, this is the value we need to ping. And then you can go to any browser in your PC. Example, I will go this browser. I will write 127.0.0.1 and then colon and this value, whatever I copy, and press enter. So you will have the controller login page. Same like SDN controller, we have the different controller. Later we are going to discuss. So like we have the network controller, we are accessing with the our browser. So here you need to create the account. So let me create as admin, username admin as a password, and I will write admin, same thing. Let me check, I wrote same here. After that I will create setup. So we create the account. Now we can log in. I will write admin and I will write admin. After that I will click, so it will add. So you will have the like this dashboard. It will show you the same like what we can say, we have the SNMP, simple network management protocol. We have dashboard, like this same dashboard we have here. We can go here in that one, we can add the device. We can go here like, let me add the device. So what I can do, I can create the device. Before that one, I can go here, I can create one user here, local user. So I will give here, let me give same thing. If it is not accepting, then we will make different. Let's see it will accept or not. I will write username admin, admin, description also admin. For lab purpose I am using this one, we can use any other different. So now I created one user in this one. So what we can do, I can go here in the discover or here in the network device. I can click this one. I can write the IP address, whatever device I want to add in the controller. Controller means we have one controller. He is going to show us device health, device IP address, device software, all the device detail, and we can control also that device. So if I want to add here, I can write 192.168.1.1. Okay. And after that, which login, this one, I will click add. So it will take time and it will add here. Maybe here it is not taking. It will come here, but anyhow, let me here it came, but it is saying inactive. So it will take time and then it will active. We need to refresh sometime. Let me add the device here. What I done, discover device. Here I can give the IP address range or I can write CDP. If I write CDP means Cisco Discovery Protocol they are going to use and they are going to add that one. So let's try. I will write any IP address 192.168.1.1 and try, or we can give the range also. Let's see, it is giving inactive. Still, it is not discover. Still, it is not discover. So what I can do? I can go for range. I will give any name. We can give any name. Let me give a network for you, and I will give you give the range 192.168.1.1. I have 1.1 till I have 192.168.1.10. Whatever IP address I am using in my network, I can select and I can press this one. So it will take time and then it will discover here. Stop and then run. But sometime it is not working. We need to reboot this packet tracer. When I use the range, because just now I test this one, it's working in another lab. But here, okay, let me go for the real. We are in the simulation. So now let's try. See, we are in the simulation. That's why it is not working. Just now I click the real. So now it will start working. So it is working. It is giving the, it is loading. It is saying in progress, and it will, after completing this one, it will do this one. So manually we can add, or automatically it will done. So if you see, if you click here, whatever information we wrote, they will check that one. We don't have IP for 00, but this one we have R1. So what is R1? We have the router R1, and this is IP. It is added, and whatever IP address is not there, it is not present, just we added, so not valid. And what else we can do? I will add some more device. Example, what device we have? This one, R2. So I will write 192.168.1.2. So I will write here range, any name, whatever name you want to give. Example, R2. I will give R2. I will give 192.168.12.1. Okay, and 12.2, 192.168, 12.2. And after that, we will take this one, we will press add. It will take time and it will add. Actually, we are, it is added. So if you see what we have router reachable. And if you want to check the detail, you can check the detail. Same thing, we can add whatever router we want to add. Example, what I will do, I will take range. I will write here what else we can add. This 2 came, 12.1, 12.2 came, so 23. So I will take this one as R3. I can write 192.168.23.1, and this one 192.168.23.2. And I will select this one and add. So it will take time, and then again we will have the device, all the device. We can discover this one, and if we refresh, it will come. See here, whatever device we discover till now, this one is completed, this one is completed. If you need information, we will get this information. And after that, we will go here and we will click the dashboard. So in dashboard, it will show us how many devices are connected and whatever the health of that device, it is working good, or we have any alarm or anything, any issue, we can verify like this. Maybe now you will not have the idea, but when you play with this one, you will have the idea. It is showing we have two PCs, and this is a MAC address of the PC, and this is the IP address of the PC, and this is a name of the PC. It is connected to switch, and this is a interface of that one, and topology. We did not add. If you want to ping also, we can ping here. We need to write the source and destination and press OK. It will show it is working or not, pinging or not. Like that, we can have the many option in this one. Before we don't have, so now they add this option. So we can utilize this one also. And what else here? We can apply the policy like quality of service. If you want to apply some policy, like this guy cannot use the internet more than 10 GB per day, we can apply that policy here. And we have some setting here, AAA server. And we can apply the API. API we can use here. So many options they added here. Now they make this more better compared to previous one. Okay. So here, you, whenever we are added all the devices here, we will have all device history. We add only few, not all. When we add all, we will have all the detail here. here in this one, how many device added and whatever is here, it is saying unsupported. So we need to check why it is unsupported. Status, maybe we need to update or we need to check. After that, we can add more device and we can monitor the device from the dashboard, health of the device. Okay, so this is just basic introduction about the new packet tracer. We have this new feature. What first feature is, you can check the physical and you can make like this. You can add one more table and you can keep more PCs, laptop, change the colors of the cable, move the routers, switches. And there is one option also, if you click here, it will become big. Not showing here, but let me see. Zoom in. There is one option, if we click, it will come outside, but here it is not coming. They add that feature also. Inspect, yeah, this way. So when we click like this, it will come outside. You can zoom in and zoom out and check that one. How I am getting this one, you need to click here, any rack, and inspect frame. If you want to do inspect rear backside, and you can do this one. If you want to delete, you can delete. Example, what is backside of this router, you can check this way, and what is front size, you can check this way by making zoom in, zoom out. Okay, so these are the new feature is available, and if you see it like this, maybe you will feel like you have physical device, you are connected like this way, and you have controller feature here. Okay, so let me stop.